Imagine walking into a factory where machines talk to each other, monitor their own health, and predict failures before they occur, saving thousands and preventing unplanned downtime. This is the Industrial Internet of Things, or IIoT, and in this series, I will show you how to build your own smart industrial systems step by step using affordable hardware and open source software. Before we dive in, let's zoom out for a moment. The IIoT is part of a big story, the fourth industrial revolution, which is the same as Industry 4.0. Industry 1.0 started with mechanization using steam power. Industry 2.0 brought electricity and assembly lines. Industry 3.0 introduced automation and PLCs. And now, Industry 4.0, where machines, sensors, and data are all connected to make factories smart. The IIoT takes IoT technology of sensors, data, and the cloud and applies it to industrial environments where there are machines, transmitters, actuators, controllers, and the SCADA system at large. IIoT intelligently monitors processes, optimizes performance, automates complex decisions, predicts failures before they happen, and automatically triggers maintenance. Take, for example, vibration and temperature sensors on a pump stream data through a gateway for analysis and trigger maintenance automatically. This is one of the most common IIoT applications, predictive maintenance. To understand how the Industrial Internet of Things systems work, let's break them down into five layers. The first is made up of sensors, actuators, PLCs, and instruments that measure temperature, vibration, pressure, and other parameters. Data is reliably exchanged from this layer in real time with other layers using various forms of connectivity. Connectivity is the layer that moves data from devices to the edge or cloud using wired or wireless networks in real time. Common wired protocols include Modbus, Ethernet IP, and Profinet, while wireless options include Wi-Fi, LoRaWAN, 4G, 5G, and Bluetooth. This layer is the backbone of IIoT. At the edge, close to the machines, small computers or gateways like Raspberry Pi, Siemens IoT 2040, or advanced tech devices process data locally using tools like Node-RED, Eclipse Cura, AWS IoT Greengrass, or Azure IoT Edge for timely response. Once the data is processed, it moves to the cloud for storage, analytics, and AI. Here is where big data platforms and machine learning models turn raw numbers into insights. Open source platforms such as ThingsBoard, FIWARE, or Eclipse Kapua store, visualize, and analyze the data. Commercial platforms to consider are AWS IoT Core, Azure IoT Hub, and Siemens MindSphere. And finally, applications and dashboards, where operators use web dashboards and mobile apps to visualize performance, receive maintenance alerts, work orders, and MES integrations to close the loop. Typical tools are Grafana, Power BI, or built-in dashboards in cloud platforms. Traditional industrial systems used to be closed, expensive, and difficult for students or small businesses to access. But open source software has changed that. Today, anyone, even a student with a laptop, can build a complete Industry 4.0 solution. For example, you can use Node-RED to read Modbus data from your Arduino Nano PLC, send that data over MQTT to ThingsBoard, store it in InfluxDB, visualize it in Grafana, and even integrate AI with FIWARE or Kapua. IIoT powered by open source software gives you freedom, flexibility, and learning by doing. The benefits of IIoT are massive, but it's not all smooth sailing. They include reduced downtime, improved efficiency, better product quality, enhanced safety, and lower operational costs. The challenges are integrating legacy machines, ensuring cybersecurity and data privacy, managing massive data volumes, and finding skilled engineers to maintain systems. But as open source ecosystems grow and edge computing gets smarter, these challenges are being solved faster than ever. In the next videos, we will go from theory to hands-on practical. You will learn how to connect the open source PLCs to ThingsBoard using Modbus and MQTT. Set up a Node-RED Edge Gateway on Raspberry Pi, and even integrate OPC UA. By the end of this series, whether you are a student, maker, or automation engineer, you will know how to design and build your own open source Industry 4.0 system. If you are excited about this, hit hype and like to tell YouTube you want more IIoT content. Subscribe and turn on notifications for frequent open source IIoT tutorials. Comment if you want OutC Studio with Arduino Nano or FL Prog with ESP8266 or ESP32. I'll pin the top pick because the next episode will show you exactly how to connect your first open source PLC to the cloud. Share this video to make Industry 4.0 accessible for everyone, from students to professionals. Thanks for watching, and remember, the future of industry is connected.